Good morning. It is Friday, April 29th, 2022, 11:09 a.m. Pacific Time. Hope you're doing well. This is going to be a prayer for all of us, for our lives, for our family, for our neighbors, cities and towns we live in, counties, state, our country, United States of America, and the world. I know that's big, but God so loved the world, so he sees the bigger picture, okay? So, but he can get right down into the nitty-gritty of our lives, and we can intercede for the world and those around us and expect God to work and pray that he works. And God is a good God. God is good. So let's pray this prayer, okay? And the devil behind the scene, your wicked spirit from hell, we have your number, devil, but you were defeated by the blood and the cross of Jesus Christ. Get out. We bind you in the name of Jesus. Psalm 141, Lord, I cry unto thee, make haste unto me, give ear unto my voice when I cry unto thee. Let my prayer be set forth before thee as incense, and the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth, yea, Lord, so I don't have to delete my tweets. Keep the door of my lips, incline not my heart to any evil thing, to practice wicked works with men that work iniquity, and let me not eat of their dainties. Let the righteous smite me, it shall be a kindness, and let him reprove me, it shall be an excellent oil, which shall not break my head, for yet my prayer also shall be in their calamities. When their judges are overthrown in stony places, they shall hear my words, for they are sweet. Our bones are scattered at the grave's mouth, as when one cutteth and cleaveth wood upon the earth. But mine eyes are unto thee, O God the Lord. In thee is my trust. Leave not my soul destitute. Keep me from the snares. I'm looking at the time on this computer, and I'm past 2:20, so that's okay. But mine eyes are unto thee, O God the Lord. In thee is my trust. Leave not my soul destitute. Keep me from the snares which they have laid for me and the gins of the workers of iniquity. Let the wicked fall into their own nets, whilst thou I withal escape. And when we're talking about the wicked and the enemy, yeah, we could be talking about people. People that sometimes can't even help their own wickedness, because the devil is so evil that he can grab somebody's life and work through them, even to the point of violence, okay? And so we pray over people, even criminals, that can't help it. Now, I'm not saying they can't help it, because they can help it, okay? We have to, well, I'm not saying we have to do anything. I'm just saying we can, as intercessors, pray and help take authority over the enemy. And I mean, sometimes it is pure work, okay? Blood, sweat, and tears, so to speak. But if you love God, and you love your family, and you love this earth, and you love God, and you love your country, you will pray and take authority over the devil in Jesus' name, and pastors in churches will rise up and start teaching their congregations. Just read the simple gospel, all of it, and what Jesus said at the end before he left, before he was, taken up into heaven, okay? He talked about us taking authority over the devil, and it's not just about that. But if we're going to expect our prayers to get answered and God to give us what he really wants, we have to, okay? Now, I was thinking about this morning out on my little jog. God had a plan on this earth, the Garden of Eden. He He had a plan that this earth would be the most amazing thing. And he created people, and he created animals. And he had good thoughts about this earth and for the people that he put in this earth. And I believe that his dream for this earth has not been fulfilled yet before the end times. I believe we as the church need to step up our prayer life. Not, you know, get on our knees, you know, no, just incorporate it into your real life. It doesn't have to disrupt your life. You know, religion, if you think it's religion, doesn't have to. Let it be like drinking water. Let it be like breathing the air. Now, I could go into some really difficult things that some would have real difficult listening to. You might already have difficulty watching me or listening to me talk about God and the Word of God, and you know, you've read in the Bible about women shall not blah blah blah. Okay, fine. But did you read the part in Galatians that there's neither male nor female? There's neither Jew nor Greek in Galatians? Read that part, okay? So, and if you have a problem with it, then that's whatever. I'm sorry. You don't have to watch this video, and of course you probably aren't. So anyway, what I was saying was, and I'm going to wrap this up as soon as possible. My thought is, if we as the church could do our part and see this earth, and I know God has told us about the end times, and yeah, we could be in the end times, but we could be in the end times at any day of any day since Jesus was taken out of this earth, okay? So what if he doesn't come tomorrow? We have to live with the consequences of what's going on and the consequences of our prayerlessness, okay, church? Okay, now, I'm not here to tell you what to do. This is what I do, okay? And if I can encourage you, I'm not trying to encourage you to do everything or anything that I do. I'm just trying to inspire you to, I believe a lot of what I'm saying is true, okay? So I know I'm rambling now, and Lord, please continue to bless and protect. These are my things I pray about. Bless and protect and deliver and keep safe. Provide, heal, healthy lives. Provide every need and save people. Save the world, Lord, that you died for. We come against accidents and close calls and car accidents, plane accidents, child abductions in Jesus' name. These things, we come against them. Church, pray, okay? And it doesn't have to be hard, okay? Just make it part of your lifestyle, okay? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great day, and God bless.